Hi, I'm Sean Lessard.
And I'm Karen Loerke, and we are consultants with support for staff and students
at Edmonton Public Schools. Well, I work at various schools across the district from kindergarten to grade 12, and I work a lot with students who are preparing for the transition to university. So I work really closely with Aboriginal studies and, of course, trying to fuse literacy components into schools.
My work is in the classroom with teachers, looking at best practices. I also work in interventions, high school intervention, middle years intervention, and this year I'm working in FM&I. But I get to work with consultants from other disciplines, such as FM&I, diversity, ELL, and I think we have grown stronger. We understand each other better. We understand each other's work, and actually, we're talking the same language often, just different lens, different perspectives. I think that's been a very strong. I hope you're not taking this. You're going to cut this part out, right?
Well, I really think it's so important to think about the historical perspectives with the First Nation, Métis, Inuit people, but also to think about that in terms of our own classrooms, that we need practical application, and it goes much beyond, way beyond just First Nation, Métis, Inuit issues, that we need to really start to begin to understand and continue to understand who students are in our classroom.
Can't separate language from culture. As a teacher in the classroom, I know that I was always hesitant to bring up FM&I issues, afraid that I would say the wrong thing. And I think walking away from this module, you'll feel more comfortable with the language, FM&I, strategies, wise practices, and teaching the FM&I
curricular
outcomes.
Well, some people say that you have to look inward before you can start to look outward. So what I'm trying to say is that we have to examine our own practices and our own perspectives so we can begin to start to explore some of those difficult topics in FM&I perspectives. And by coming to the museum, to a place where there's a lot of living knowledge, where there's stories all around us, we'll begin to examine things in such a different way, and the words will start to become more alive to us.
And how do you bring words alive and get kids thinking about identity? And this is a teepee liner, which is much like a winter count. And on this teepee liner, that there's so many different stories, and it's so contextual. We're in Treaty 6 territory in Edmonton. But you can even recognize what community and what place, you know, geographically, by the imagery.
It really is about making connections. And when we do a walkthrough with our students or with teachers at the museum, there's wonderful artifacts throughout in the form of pictures, beading, clothing. They all hold meaning in different ways. And it is really about making those connections to those experiences. Because words will do so much, but then if you can pull on different modalities with students and with teachers, then we can begin to explore the topics in rich ways. So I always look at the River Valley with the students, and we think about, imagine what this place looked like, because a lot of the trees here were introduced well after. And this whole idea of the River Valley was just barren. The people called this, right down by Rossdale Flats, they called it the Pohonan, where the Upcourt Site Center is. It was a meeting place, it was a gathering place. And down here on this River Valley, they talked about it as, old people talk about it as almost an international trade route. So I get kids to think about imagining a place, stripping the trees away, and thinking of that, of what was it like before all those skyscrapers existed and those bridges, and what were the stories. I get to meet a lot of dynamic teachers across the district to go in different classes and hear about their stories in terms of how, and their successes and some of their challenges working with students. One of the best parts is seeing the kids, and have 18 students at the University of Alberta studying to be teachers right now, and that, to me, hearing their stories of what life's like in university just keeps me rolling.
I think I'm passionate about literacy because I think it changes lives. I think it opens doors, opens minds, explores thoughts, ideas, and it helps students communicate their thoughts, and a whole new world out there when you can read and write well. I think I really appreciate Sean's story. He's very philosophical. It's quite random at times, and keeping him on topic has always been a lot of fun. Sean likes to call us the literacy nerds, literacy groupies. We walk around with books, literacy books, research studies. We're all talking about new research ideas, and Sean thinks this is quite funny that we live and breathe this work, but we do.